Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Here's the One Show. You could also call it Risen, I suppose. It's great that you could all make it. I'm very much looking forward to the show and what a packed show we have for you tonight. It's going to be a lot of fun and some serious bits in it as well. Just in case you feel the urge, there to my left. And if you feel the other urge, it's to my right. Teas and coffees. You can also take some on your way out. There's a toddler area at the far end. If you wish to frequent it, if you're a toddler, you're very welcome to. Just make sure it stays He's the One Show and not Casualty or Bradcamp. But I'm sure we won't have that problem at all. And a packed show. We've got some excellent music all the way from Morecambe. Nanette and the small band is performing two jazz sets and then her album called It's Personal, which you could also purchase on later in the evening. And the question really is, this evening, is he the one? Is this Jesus the one? I'm not sure if you heard, but just over the last couple of days or so, there have been rumors spreading that this Jesus has risen. And Tony, my co-host, and I went to investigate over the last few days to find out more about this Jesus and if he really is the one he says he is. And so, earlier on in the week, I went to see the restaurant manager of the place where Jesus allegedly had the Last Supper with his disciples, trying to dig a little deeper on who this Jesus actually is. And let's just watch the clip.
Well, I'm here in Jerusalem City, in the very restaurant that Jesus and his disciples had their final meal together. I've got with me here the restaurant manager. Thank you for joining me, and her husband. And tell me, what was it like that evening when Jesus and his disciples came to dine at your place?
It was a really busy night.
Was it? I didn't notice.
You wouldn't. There was a lot of people in and out, in and out. Seeing as it was the Passover coming up, that people were just coming in to eat. And so yeah, it was a really busy evening.
Right. Can you remember how many people
that... I wasn't that rushed off my feet.
You never are.
I do understand it was a very busy evening for you, but what exactly did they have to eat?
They didn't have anything other than water to begin with, and later on, the man named Jesus, he asked for just a loaf of bread and some wine.
Right, right.
Expensive wine as well. They're not paying me for this, I don't want to talk to them.
Can I just ask you what the mood was like amongst the disciples?
It started off a pretty happy night. They all just came, they were having a good time.
Making lots of noise, they were.
It's a noisy restaurant. But I noticed that Jesus' group, as the night went on, and once they had ordered the bread and the wine, it got a little more solemn, a little, I don't know, not calmer, but would you agree?
I wasn't looking. I was busy.
We know you were busy.
Now, Jesus wasn't alone on that night, was he? Can you recall how many disciples were with him that night?
He had a reservation, so it was 12? Would you say there was 12?
I wasn't looking.
You never look. I think there was 12, and plus Jesus. And one of them actually stormed out halfway through the evening.
Right. Would you happen to know who that was?
Did he pay?
Yes, he paid. Put the newspaper down.
I'm reading.
Sorry, what was your question?
Can you recall who stormed out during the meal?
Who was it? Do you remember who it was?
I wasn't looking.
You weren't looking, I'm sorry. Judas. I think that's the name I heard them call, Judas.
Excellent. Now, of course, we would all have liked to be a fly on the wall on that evening, and I'm sure as you served, you overheard the odd comment or two. Can you remember any of the things that were said at the table?
Not for the most part. As I said, it was really busy, so it was quite loud. But there was one part when I brought out the bread and the wine to them. Jesus, he took the bread and he broke it and he said, "This is my body broken for you." And then the wine, when he took the wine and he passed it around, and he said, "This is my blood shed for you."
Sounds weird to me.
I'd have to agree with him on that one. I gave him bread and wine, but yeah.
Would you know the meaning of this at all?
I haven't the faintest idea. Nobody comes in here and asks, it's just for bread and wine, and then I don't understand why you would break bread and call it a body. No.
Right. What about you, sir? What is your view on this?
As long as they're paid, they can say what they want. As long as they pay up. I'm too busy, aren't I?
Busy.
I wasn't really paying a lot of attention.
You never pay attention.
What?
Exactly. Now, would you put the paper down? You're on TV.
Yeah, but I'm reading and I didn't ask them to come. TV. And they're not paying for this, are they? So it's just taking up my precious time and valuable money. What I was reading now.
Thank you very much for your time anyway, and thank you for your time, sir.
Put the paper down.
I tell you, it was terrible. I've never interviewed anybody like that.
No, I'm glad you got the short straw there, Michael. Yeah.
Oh, dear. I mean, she was very patient with him, goodness me. But
yeah, no, I don't envy her really in that situation. But it really was kind of strange to think that there's this man, Jesus, the one that people have been following. People welcomed him to the city a few days ago with all those hosannas. Talking about his body being broken as if he kind of knew what was going to come next.
Yeah. And some people obviously didn't have the faintest idea what all that could mean. You know, like the lady, for example.
Yeah.
Not sure about the husband, but anyway.
We have had a text sent in about this saying, according to the ancient text, talks about in Isaiah 53, the suffering servant of God. So, you know, a lot of people do believe that Jesus is the one, and he knew that he was going to suffer. So maybe that's what it was all about. I don't really know.
Right. By the way, there's also an opportunity for you to text in live this evening. Phone number's on the screen. It's a working phone. Normal text charges apply. So whatever you normally pay for your text, send it. And if it's worth reading out, we'll read it out as the show progresses. And that'll be all very exciting, I'm sure. Be nice to hear from you as well. Now what?
Well, Michael, I think it's time to have Nanette and the band on, and we'll have some music, please.
Sounds good to me.
Okay. Thanks, Michael.